G'day YouTubers and welcome to another video. In this episode I'm going to be setting up a solar charger on my boat. There's a couple of reasons for that. Primarily, when I get back from a trip I have to run a lead down to my boat port which doesn't have any power, and I charge the batteries then after I get back, make sure they're fully charged, pack it all away, then before I go out again run the lead back down, make sure the batteries are fully charged, pack it all away again. I'm getting a bit tired of that, so I thought I'd set up a solar system on the roof so that I can put it on the day I get back, take it off the next day. I don't like the idea of leaving batteries permanently on charge, and do the same the day before I go out and just give it another top up then. Just saves me the hassle of rolling out 100 metres of lead and wrapping it up again. The other reason is that I'm going to put a solar panel on the boat, one of the ones that you fold away, nothing permanent. I'm going to put that on the boat so that I can put it out when I'm out and overnighting. And I also have this thing on my wish list of going up to the reef with Sundays, somewhere around the reef area, maybe Lady Elliot, Lady Musgrave, something like that, and spending two or three nights out there, in which case I'm going to need something to charge the batteries. So anyway, that's the motivation behind it. Let's get on and have a look how it's done. And what I'm doing now is I'm setting up a solar charger on the boat. That's the control unit for it. Two reasons for doing this. One is I don't have a power point down here, so I've got to drag a lead all the way down to the boat port every time I need to charge it. And the other reason is that I want to be able to take out a solar panel, a flexible solar panel, throw it up on the bimini and charge the batteries from the sun while I'm fishing. That's for times when I stay out more than a couple of days overnight. If I ever get up to the reef, 1770, somewhere like that, I want a few days out on the boat. So that's the idea, get prepared. As part of it, I've got this Victron unit. Well, they're both Victron units, it's a Victron solar thing. And this is to charge different batteries, so I thought I may as well throw this one on at the same time. This is my Victron charger that I have to drag the lead down for. So, get that out of the way. And I've got this paired cable here that happens to be the right size for the job. And rather than buy some separate cable, I'm just going to pull this all apart and use the red side for the positives. A little bit of the black for the negative. I don't have any other real use for it, so I may as well use some of it on this job. I didn't show drilling these holes, that's pretty obvious how you do that. This hole here I put in for the solar plug. Now I just got to remember that pin 1 is positive and pin 2 is negative. When I'm thinking about the battery terminals, I always think of positive and negative in that order. So one is positive, negative is two. Just got to remember that so when I wire up other plugs to plug into it, they're wired up the same. This hole here is for the electric reel plug. Now I've got a really heavy duty plug for that because I couldn't find anything that was exactly right for it. So I got another plug for a Minn Kota trolling motor, which is basically a 50-60 amp plug, and all I really need for the electric reel is 30 amps, but it is what it is, so I've got this one. I like the idea of it better because I can screw the wires in for the electric reel, and those wires are kind of sensitive, so it's a good idea to do it that way. I went to the shop this morning and I got some extra eyes that I didn't have for this size wire. And because they're bare metal wires, I had intended to buy some heat shrink to go over it to seal it. And I forgot to get that. I saw it there, it was right there, but by the time I'd finished getting all the wire and stuff I needed, I just picked it all up and forgot about the heat shrink. I should have got it out when I thought about it first, but anyway. Where there's a will, there's a way. I've got this liquid electrical tape here. So I'm going to put some of that on the critical areas to seal moisture out of the system. I'll just sit this there to dry for a bit. where it, if it drips, it won't do any harm, and that'll fix that job. Make up another one for the other side, and we'll get this Victron, or VSR for want of a better word, but it's a lithium and AGM battery splitter. Doing any work on a boat electrical system, it's really pretty easy. All you need is an attention to detail and some basic tools. You want a good set of crimpers. I've got these because I crimp all size terminals. But depending on what sort of crimps you're using, a good set of crimpers like this is an option. Don't get those cheap things off the auto shops, they're not worth having. Spend the money and get a decent set, because then you don't have to redo your wires. You know that they're crimped properly. Always buy proper marine cable, which is copper wire tinned, and marine cable has a thicker insulation sheath on it. Just pare back enough insulation to fill up the terminal area, whatever the length of your terminal piece is. And as I say, this is a hydraulic one. It does a particularly good job on these types of terminals. But anything that does a good crimp on the terminals is fine. I just happen to do enough of it, I can justify having a really good crimper. You see, that won't come off now. No way that's coming off. And as I said earlier, I didn't pick up the heat shrink. I'm really annoyed at that, but instead I can fix that with some liquid electrical tape. Just put that all around that joint area there on both ends. And let that set. Doesn't take too long to set. Set it on something that doesn't matter if it drips a little bit. And it's all ready to put on where it needs to go. I've soldered the wire onto this plug now, and I put a piece of heat shrink around each wire, a bit of thinner heat shrink around each wire, and then I put the larger heat shrink over both wires just to stop them from coming apart and to make sure everything's protected so nothing touches it. Also, it will help the solder joint, because I hate solder joints on a boat. Back when I was young and didn't know any better, I used to solder wires on a boat and they were no end of grief. So I don't do it anymore, but the idiots that made this plug decided that soldering was the better option, so I don't have any choice. I could buy a cheap plug, or I could pay $70 each for a plug that doesn't have solder joints, and this didn't make sense. I thought I'd try the cheap ones first. I can always go and spend more on it if I need to, but seeing as I needed a couple of them, I thought it was best to try these first. And in the time it took me to do that, this liquid electrical tape's dry, so I can finish that job as well. I got all these plugs mounted now. That's the one that was there. That's for the spotlight. That's new. That's for the solar charger. I can plug in a solar panel into that, and it'll go down to the solar charging controller. And that's for my electric reel for deep dropping. I just got to finish wiring them up inside, but so far so good. It's a fiddly job, takes a long time, but there's not actually that much to it. I've decided I'm going to mount this up here. I've put a new piece of board in there to screw it to, because the other one just wasn't quite right, having been used for something else which has been since removed. But this will do the job nicely. However, I have botched up one thing. I wired the VSR, again for want of a better word, in the same way I had it wired previously, which was what I wanted, the way it ran before. But for charging the solar system, I want it wired directly into the two batteries. I did not think of that when I did this. So I've got to redo that, which is quite annoying, but unfortunately it is entirely necessary. So I'll get this in first and then I'll see about doing that. Not going anywhere. Now I can work out how much wire I need on this, which is coming from the solar system, and I'll want to cut him off right about there, I guess. I'm getting all this mounted up now. I screwed the solar controller onto the board. I have a wire here going over to connect to this VSR, but it follows through, it just connects to the wire that connects to the battery. So it's just basically the same as connecting this wire straight to the battery, only I've just tied it off on the terminal there. The other one goes to the lithium ion battery, and this one goes to an earth up there. Mainly because I just didn't want to have a whole heap of wires going back to the batteries. And the same with this earth orb here to the battery, it actually goes up to there as well. And of course the other two wires out of here go up to the plug that I put in to plug the solar system, solar panel into. So I've got to make up some labels just to remind me about what's what, but that's basically finished there now for this part. I've just got to heat shrink this on and then put it up onto here, and that has everything electrically finished down this end.
This is a shot of the solar panels that I put up on the roof. Don't worry about the little one on the right, that's a small solar panel for the lights in the boat shed. Because I leave so early in the morning, I need some light to hook up the trailer. But the one on the left-hand side of the shed is the one for charging the batteries. Now, don't leave it connected all the time. I connect it for a few hours on the day before I leave, and I connect it when I come back to make sure the batteries are charged up, and I leave it on for however long it takes to charge the batteries. I just keep checking the charge on the phone. It's a lot easier than dragging a lead across the yard, although if it's been pretty dull, I still have to drag the lead out, so it's not a total solution. But it does go a long way to making life easier. And that's what it's all about. You want life to be easy. At least I do. I ended up swapping out the flexible solar panel for a folding one. I was lucky enough to be able to do that. It's no stronger than the other one. They're both given equal amount of power. The folding one's much heavier than the flexible one was, but it makes up for that by being much easier to store in a trailer boat. Folds up into this nice, neat little package. It's even got a pocket to put all your leads in, and it's got front and back straps to tie it onto the boat. A little bit different to tie it on. I had to work out a different system to do that, but it's all very good now. And this is just a quick shot from my phone of the solar panel in use. As you can see, it provides the amount of power, and of course that depends on the angle of the sun, the amount of cloud around, etc., 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 because renewable energy might be renewable, but it's not reliable. So it certainly wouldn't be depending on this to charge the batteries, but as an adjunct to the engine alternator, it's pretty good. I'm one of these fellows that likes to keep his sounder on while I'm fishing so that I can see what's happening down below. I don't believe it affects the fish at all. So I'm burning a lot of energy while I'm fishing. And if I'm fishing for any length of time, it's nice to know the batteries are getting charged a little bit while I'm doing it. In case you didn't know, we can thank Albert Einstein for the theory behind solar cells. He's not just responsible for E equals MC squared and the theories of special and general relativity, but also solar cells, as well as quite a few other things. Really, a true genius. Well, that wraps up this video. If you're planning to fit a solar system to your boat, I hope this is of some help. With any luck and the weather gods permitting, the next video will be out on the water. Until then, good fishing.